Greetings, galactic travelers. I was going to say hail and well met, but doesn't really fit this game. But the RPG chick has returned. My apologies for my long absence, almost a year long. I'm gonna have another video out before this video is released anyway. That my schedule going forward and why I was gone for so long. So I'm not gonna gab about that here because that would take up quite a bit. So see that video if you have questions about that. I want to thank Patreon members who have stuck with me all this time. Wouldn't blame you if you didn't. Sophie is a ghost. Herman Hillman and Amy Flory, thanks so much for all your support through the years, really. You've been supporting me quite a few years. Patreon, I do have, in case anyone wants to donate. The link is in the description for that, and also Ko-fi or Ko-fi, coffee, however you say it. If you just want to leave like a little tip or something, or a one-time donation or something like that. Not required. Don't blame anyone for not doing so. But if you wish to, there it is, and I thank you. Just a few things. I read all the things, for those who haven't seen my Let's Plays before. I read everything, almost everything. I play slowly and thoroughly, methodically, so that tends to drive some people insane. So if that drives you insane, yeah, sorry, maybe not watch. And this is not a walkthrough, this is a playthrough, this is a blind Let's Play, meaning I have never played this before. So this is my first time. I have played a little tiny bit just to get the sound levels and, you know, make sure everything's working right. All I did was talk to a few miners, and you know, I was being led on a tour through a mining facility, and yeah, didn't get very far. So maybe played less than 5 minutes of this. So I'm excited. I'm not gonna read this though. This is like their thank you. Starfield. Yeah, this is gonna be going up every other day episode. So the schedule beyond that, yeah, like I said, see my other video, and I think that's all I had to say. This is the credits crew, what they call it. Photo gallery, obviously nothing in there. And I'm probably not going to be messing around with photo mode too much. And I like to show people my settings, I don't know, whatever. I never see anyone else do it, but yeah. Difficulty, normal. Saving, save on pause, I don't think that's necessary. I turn that off. Display. I am playing on Windows 10 with an RTX 3060 NVIDIA card, so. Generic monitor. How insulting. So I just did custom. I did ultra and high for like everything except for the crowd density, because I know that's more like a CPU intensive thing. And I don't have the newest, latest CPU. I have an i7-2550, I think. So. I don't know. Check my about section of the channel if you really want to know what kind of CPU I am running. But I had slowdowns with Cyberpunk 2077 with the crowd density. Ended up turning that down. So I made it medium here as well. I do not like motion blur. I turn that off. I mean, it's okay, but... Upscaling. Oh yeah. So this looks like only for AMD cards. So I have NVIDIA. Film grain, I don't like that either. So that's that stuff. Depth of field. Only on or off. You can't set it to a setting, which is weird. Interface. Yeah, I have this. I showed the damage numbers. All this is subject to change, guys, if I don't like it or if it doesn't work that well. Controls. Could be adjusting that. my key bindings. I use, for those who don't know, I've only mentioned it a few times, I use something called a Thrustmaster tactical board. So that's why I have up, down, left, right instead of WASD. So I've changed the keys to, you know, work with that board. I don't know. I changed some of this stuff around. I had binding conflicts with everything. So I changed some of those keys just to remove the binding conflicts, because up, down, left, right were for something else. I think for photo mode. And there was something conflicting with the post, the outposts. So I changed that around as well. Like something's powering on here. I adjusted pretty much all these. Well, not the effects. I think I changed that the same. I changed master, voices, music, just so you can hear me over it. And accessibility I didn't mess with. Subtitles are already on. Yeah, so. That is it. So, new. Bethesda Game Studios presents Starfield! Soul date, May 7th, 2330. Argos Extractor's Mining Outpost, Moon of Vectera. Well, at least it wasn't the moon of Vecna. Can you imagine if it was the moon of Vecna? An entire moon? Say goodbye to the universe. Hi. I can't move yet. I guess she's gonna undo me.
Seals are good. Oxygen's good. Just do what you did last time, and you're fine. Follow my one simple rule.
What did I do last time?
Hella, what's my one simple rule?
Listen to Lynn. Boss lady knows best.
Exactly.
Listen to you?
Listen to me. Mining's just like any other job. Go steady, go safe, go home with a pocket full of credits at the end of the day.
Yeah, totally. It's just like, I work in the Star Dock, except with more cave-ins, lasers, and accidental dismemberment.
Okay.
Very helpful. Thank you.
You're gonna be fine. Your first outing was solid. And, you know, let's be honest, it ain't exactly astrophysics.
That's why I keep him around. Good pep talks.
Yeah, and the fact that I can pinpoint a helium deposit from 300 meters.
Not
can't
untrue.
Move yet.
A shame we won't find any down here.
Can't move forward.
But the metal deposits alone should pay for our own helium. Hell, after this, we'll have enough jump fuel to bounce from one end of the settled systems to the next.
Hey, more minerals, more money. And so the cycle repeats itself.
No more unauthorized jumps in a house for room space, okay?
He's just a big baby. There are worse lives.
Okay.
You know, most Dusties don't even make it this far.
Dusties.
I have a good feeling about you.
Group
is your name
Mort? At the end of the shift.
One of these days, Hella, I am going to leave you behind.
Promises, promises.
Mort from Planescape Torment called the Dustmen the Dusties. I can move.
Okay, let's see what we've got. How are we on time?
A little longer.
Grab
some samples.
Jump.
Always. But not you. Check on Isabel. Make sure she eases up on the breach. I don't feel like getting buried alive today.
They're busy.
Roger that.
Remember, Dusty, keep your breathing steady. And never take that helmet off down here. Oxygen processors don't extend this far.
Yeah, because God forbid we drill on a rock with breathable atmosphere.
Know what I love about working in Freestock Collective space? Pure pay. A job like this in the United Colonies? Huh. Reams of red tape.
Hi.
You think we'll be done here soon? Now I hear this is the last dig.
Oh yeah? What?
Talbot! No! Ah, no, no, no! It's a laser, not a sledgehammer! Ease up! Benning, if you got paid per break, you'd be a millionaire! Let's go!
Yes.
Your cutter working right? I swear, you'd read
what
out
the
same
thing over here. You
Whoa.
Miss your cut, you'll get your cut. No exception. Come on, pick it up! Troy, what's the yield?
She really laying into
him. Minimal at this point. Occasional glimmer, but it's weak.
What do you think? Stay the course?
No, ma'am. Juice ain't worth the squeeze.
Well, okay then. Let's call this one tapped. Why don't you move over to that big vein we looked at?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Can I talk to these people? I wish I could sprint. I can't do that yet.
I used to be the new girl until you showed up. Lynn still gets on my case.
I think she gets on everyone's case.
I'm busy. Is there anyone else to bother?
Yeah, actually, someone over here.
You got a few more digs to go before I feel like talking to you.
Yeah, all right. It broke. Oh, there we go. See, I get closer and he stops. It's like the guys in my town with the leaf blowers. Once you get near them, they stop. And they're supposed to.
This has been a good run. You lucked out being picked up for this one.
I'll take your word for it. She's back over there. Let's see what this person has to say.
Running through these veins pretty quick.
Alright. Good work, I say. As I walk slowly over. Oh, really? Oh.
Dusty, you're up. Grab a cutter and mine what you can. Metal deposits are in that cavern. I'll shout out when I need you.
Oh, supposed to go in there?
What are you waiting for? Dig.
Cutter. Engy? Was that energy? Alright, accuracy isn't bad. Fire rate, I don't know. Cool. I kill. Oh, I can move faster now. Oh, I can sprint now!
Mind, delicate work. Busy here.
Hey, a little busy here. We'll chat out.
Oh, yeah? Can I help? I don't wonder if there's anything to pick up around here. Doesn't seem to be.
Glad when we're off this rock. Take care of yourself out there.
Thanks.
Just trying to get... What?
What?
I'm working.
Sorry, I interrupted you. I was supposed to mine that.
How'd they sucker you to join? Ball for the fancy pamphlets?
Yep.
Lynn sure seems to like you. Guess she would know, being the boss and all.
That's a good thing. Wonder how long it'll last. Oh, I see the, it instantly recharges.
Not interested. Whatever it is.
I did not even select you this time. I really am at it.
You're ready, boss. Get back up here.
Ready for me, huh?
Come on.
Busy.
It's time.
Talk to you later.
You're with me.
All I had to do was walk next to these people and they start telling me they're busy and to leave them alone. Stand back. I thought something was gonna explode.
Let her do his job. This is delicate.
Alright.
Standard's reading a clean break. Shut it down.
Cool.
Let's go.
Good work.
Hey, let's talk later.
Hela, get the readings.
Yeah, about that.
Problem?
Not if you consider a spike in gravity readings a problem.
A spike
I
in
don't.
Gravity? That can't be good.
You don't?
What we're after? It'll read as an anomaly. That's what I was told anyway.
Okay, now you're starting to freak me out.
A spike in gravity how?
It's just
lighter?
Another job. Come on.
Or heavier?
Getting close, I think. Yeah, everything is just... Lynn, seriously, there's something really effed up about this.
Oh, okay, you can go first.
Where is it, Hela?
Through there, I think.
He's
okay,
going
you,
first.
You're up.
No!
Something goes wrong in there, we'll come get you.
No, Heller's going.
Why would anything go wrong?
Would you shut up? Both of you do your jobs. Client is on his way.
I don't want to go first, I'm the new person. Flashlight. That's the problem. I don't know what keys are what on this tactical board. Let's jump. Not bad, plus. Numpad plus. Well, I want to turn the flashlight on. Yeah, I was pressing that. Oh, I have to hold it down. Okay. Good to know. Is there a monster?
Still getting weird gravity readings. I guess that's a good thing. Just keep going!
How can weird gravity readings be a good thing? Take that. That was a warning shot. Am I gonna start flying and going into zero G or something?
Do you see anything?
There's a zoom feature, I haven't discovered that yet. This would be the source of the, or the area anyway, of the gravity readings. Once I step in here, am I supposed to start floating like these rocks? Use the cutter to break up the mineral deposits. Nothing else in here. Nothing else to do. I'm not feeling particularly good about this. Take the strange object. I'm supposed to grab those deposits too. I have no idea what just happened.
Snap out of it.
I just went through like time and space or something. I think I broke the space-time continuum. What is that?
Come on, come on. Okay, take it easy. You were out cold. No physical damage. Mentally, the jury's still out.
No, mental damage, definitely.
You know who you are? New recruit for Argos Extractors? Ring any bells? Any of this look familiar?
Character creations. I swear I haven't gotten to this part. I knew they were building up to that. Okay, so this is probably going to be the rest of the video, because it always takes me forever to do this. Biometric customizations can be changed later by visiting a genetics facility. Oh, really? Biometric. So you can change your appearance at a genetics facility. That makes sense. I can rotate. Mouse 2. Wait, mouse 2. Yeah. Wait, no, that mouse 2. Nautilus. So I guess you start with one of these predefined ones and then change it to wherever you like. It looks like he should be in a metal band. Ugh. That mustache, though. Got some old timers here. Look at that. Look how their hair just goes flop, flop. Oh, I gotta change them back around. Cool hair. I like. Well, I can change the hair on the other one if I want. I wonder what's locked into this. Body, face, background. You might not be able to change the hair, I'm not sure. I don't see a hair. I see body and face. And then background, which is gotta be your, you know, your history. I don't remember what number it was. Okay. Oh, muscular, heavy. My God. That a little jarring. Thin, but yeah, I guess cross between thin and muscular. Oh, that's the dude version. You can change the style, the walking. Oh, you can see like her undergarments. What's the difference? Does this make a difference to me? Her arms look very long. Okay. I guess she swings her arms less with two. Or her arms are more to her side anyway. Yeah. This looks more natural to me. Skin tone. It's all the way. Can I zoom in or something? Huh. Yeah, I guess that's fine. Right? Okay. Hair color, you could, oh, you can change it. Well, I knew you could change the hair color, actually, but can you change the hair style? Yes, you can, okay. Well, the skin tone is here also. Alright. Head shape. Oh my god. It's like her head's about to explode. Boomp! Seven, I guess? Definitely not these big jaw ones. Seven. Refine? How do you refine it? Oh! You could change them individually. Okay. Square jaw, really? That's fine. Shaggy hair. That's... Normally I would go for hair like this, but it looks weird on this kind of face, I guess. Perhaps? 39. But I have to see all of them. I mean, the original is not bad, though. More short styles than anything else. Pixie-ish cut. Cool. Oh, I can zoom it in and out. Oh wow, you can get... Okay. I was like, how close are we gonna get till you see each individual pore? Now that would be something. What'd I say it was? 37? Or 27? No. None of the above. Sorry guys, just looking at that pixie-ish cut again. I passed it, I'm sure. Alright. Yeah, this. I think this is a good match for this, like, facial structure. I don't know. How many different hair colors? Answer to how many different hair colors? Many. Cool. Wait. Oh, this almost looks like, more like a punky orange, but where's their normal, like, red hair color? I guess it would be this. Well. I always prefer more of a flaming red, so... I don't want that red. Let's go for pinkish. Yeah, pinkish. Eyes. This changes the... Okay. So I'll see if I can refine any of the others, but... So wait. This is one. Can I? This eye looks different. Right? This eye is more wide open. This one. I don't know if that's on purpose. It looks like that to me. I'm gonna keep it at one. Oh, I can refine. Yeah, I don't see it necessary to change these things. Shape blends. Oops. Alright, so I'm just gonna keep that as this. Oh my god, there's more. I did see that, but I wasn't really looking that closely. So, eye color. We have it. Oh, that's freaky. Like implants. Wow. She's the fire starter. I like this color. Okay. Eyebrows. Tell me this is not like, it looks fine in the menu, but I mean you can change it later from what they're saying. Narrow, maybe a little narrower. Oh, not narrower. Narrower, like narrower together, okay. I wish there was an option to make them less bushy. I mean, obviously, yeah, pick a different one, but... Like this, but with, you know, I would tweeze it, the bottom part at least. Eyebrow color. I'm gonna leave that as 8, right? Unless I'm gonna go pink for the eyebrows too. I say 8, we'll keep it at that. Forehead. That'll stay the same. Nose, okay. No. See, the one thing, I forget what, was it Cyberpunk? Where the nose looked fine from the front, but then when you saw it from the side, it was like, what the hell's going on? That's a perky nose. 8. 8. 8 it is. in, out. I can't breathe here. Looks fine. That's a pretty nice looking character. The ears. Good. You can customize so much. What's the difference between 11 and 1? Is. Oh, Jesus. That's nicer, I think. Nine or one? Nine or one? So you got all these beauty marks here, and then over here, just one. Alright. Oh my god. Let's see those choppers. We're at the dentist. Hell no. Teeth were fine the way they were. Jaw. Jaw was fine the way it was. Chin. Oh, this changes the color, I think. Okay, and the musculature, I guess, in front. Either way, you still have the same beauty marks there. That's a very thin, long neck, huh? Can't really tell the difference. Well, I'll keep it the same, since I can't tell the difference. Jewelry? Okay, so 12 is with the hoop earrings. You know, we gotta accessorize. Am I zoomed? Oh, it's nose rings or nose piercing. Okay. Didn't notice. I like the hoops the way they were. Jewelry color. Can't tell the difference. I mean, they're just hoops. still like bluish. That's purple. Maybe we'll go for a little splash of purple. A little dash. Dermesthetic. What is that? Whatever it is, you can change the intensity of it. Is that just like skin color? Alright, we were at 38. I think I just keep it as is. There are a lot of dermesthetics. Okay, I'm gonna change it. I mean, not change it. Complexion, colored, oh, green. Yeah, She-Hulk. You never even thought about a character name? I have no idea. Keep that as is. Complexion, blemishes. Barely tell. Wait a second. Some of these are very subtle. Alright, I'm gonna keep it at one. I don't want scars. I never go for scars. This is the Aiello look, only that's like over her whole face. Aiello. The Joker. Jeez, poor girl. Been through a lot. Damn. Don't leave mining operations. Right, I'm gonna keep it at one. Facial forms. Oh yes, saggy. Saggy eyelids. Probably gonna be boring, guys. I'm just gonna keep it to pretty much standard for a lot of this stuff. Oh, two? In case you want both. Tattoos. Okay, what is this tattoo gonna be? Okay. She's a circuit board. Cool. Looks very black metal to me. Probably not going for the tattoos, it's just a small one. For me, tattoos do not go on the face. It looks like two hands. Like two corpse hands covering her eyes. Oh, speaking of corpse. Oh, she's got a little. Keep doing that. Alright, so that's on that side, but. I kind of like that little, the little plant leaf thing. Okay, so we'll go with that. Okay, so just a little bit of color. So it looks different to me already. Oh, and two. Oh, is this the higher blush? All right. Right. Yeah. Okay. Round three. I'll make it two here. Lipstick base, and then accents. I can't even see anything changing, really. Should I zoom in more? Lipstick accents. Oh, it's very subtle. Okay. You can't give it like red lipstick or some eyeshadow upper. Oh, we gotta zoom in again. Yoop. Yeah, that's good. Subtle, but I'll go with this. We're almost done with the face. Eyeliner upper. Why can't I have... Oh, I can change the color. Wait a second. I want black. Black. That's black. We're close to it. Brown. That one. And then lower. Dirt. Well, I can have zero. Okay. Done. Background? Oh, wow. We have like 49 minutes. Beast Hunter. From the Ashta of Aquila to the terror morphs that plagued the whole of the settled systems. Hostile alien life abounds. You've learned the skills to track them and find them and take them down. Starting skills, fitness. Ballistics. Few things stack up to the reliable power of high-speed projectiles. Increased lung capacity. No limit to the delicious foods and drinks a talented chef can prepare. Oh my god, there's so many! What? Beast Hunter, alright. So I wonder if there's any... I'm not gonna read all these. File not found. Ooh. I'll read that when we get to it. Beast Hunter. Yeah, I'll read them. I'll just read this part. But the thing is, with the background, I wonder if this is all that counts. The skills you get. It'd be cool if it was, you know, referenced during the story. So this is a bouncer. You've worked the line at the toughest clubs in the settled systems. Back then, you learned Most non-lethal confrontations can be solved one of two ways, a strong right hook or a more strongly secured door. So you start with boxing, security, any code can be broken with proper training and fitness again. Boxing, security, and fitness. Bounty hunter. Wherever they are wanted individuals, there are those who profit from their capture, and your quarry knows that in the vastness of space, they can run, but they can't hide. Piloting. Seems important. Targeting control systems. Locking onto an enemy ship. Boost pack training. Yeah, these are good for, like, exploring, too. Oh, there's a chef. While the unrefined masses scarf down chunks, capital C, is that a kind of food? Chunks? By the shipload, you cater to those with a more discerning palate. In your kitchen, countless alien species become true culinary masterpieces. So there's that gastronomy skill again, dueling. Why would a chef have dueling as a skill? Close attacks with a melee weapon can be often deadlier than ranged combat. And scavenging. Knowing how and where to look. Combat medic. Leave it to human beings to fight over something as infinite as outer space. That's where you come in. You've never been afraid to take on an enemy, but you'd much rather take care of your friends. Pistol certification. Familiarity with such weapons. Medicine. And wellness. Oh. Gain prolonged life expectancy. Is your life expectancy a thing in this game? Cyber Runner. Here we go. Back to Cyberpunk. From Neon to New Atlantis, the Megacore stand as monuments to power, prestige, and profit. You've worked both for and against them on the inside and out, often sacrificing conscience for credits. Stealth. I'm always big into stealth mechanics. Approach a target while undetected and kill with a silenced weapon. There's security again and theft. Discreetly remove property from someone's person. Cyberneticist. Robots? Mere toys. Neuro amps? Good for parlor tricks. The colony war may have made implants and upgrades available to veterans, but you once saw a greater future. Humans and machines as one. Oh boy. Isn't that the green ending? Mass Effect 3? We got medicine, security, and lasers. Personal laser weapons. Diplomat. The wars are over. Peace now reigns the settled systems, but only because there are those quietly fighting to keep it. Because of you, agreements were signed, words were heeded, lives were spared. Persuasion. Ability to listen and discuss commerce. Running a successful business in the free market economy, and wellness again. This is the Jean-Luc Picard suite. Yeah, he did have an actually pretty active lifestyle. But the Starfleet and all that did not have commerce because there was no... They never bought anything. They took money out of their society until they met the Ferengi and had a deal in gold pressed latinum. Anyway, explorer. They said exploration is a lost art. You didn't listen. As the major factions argued over the space they desperately tried to control, you were busy uncovering the wonders of the settled systems. So I got lasers again, astrodynamics. Coax even more capability out of a ship's grav drive, okay. The, Scotty role, and surveying. Decipher the data while on the ground. Pertaining to untold alien worlds. Okay. Gangster? You were always disgusted by suckers killing themselves to make an honest wage. As soon as you were old enough to hold a weapon, you took what you wanted from anyone unlucky enough to have it. Shotgun certification. Boxing and theft. Okay. Homesteader? The discovery of the settled system's many oxygen-rich planets and moons meant humans could live just about anywhere if they had the know-how. You did, and utilized it to great effect. Geology? Newly discovered minerals mined from alien planets. Oh. Like what we're doing right now. Surveying and weightlifting. Why weightlifting? Obviously carrying weapons and equipment in space on the ground. Industrialist. There was a time when all you wanted to be was a titan of industry, maybe a ship designer or a megacorp exec. Thankfully, that skill set never goes out of style in the settled systems. Persuasion, security, and research methods. Completing projects faster and gaining unexpected insights. Long hauler. Let those other hot-headed pilots obsessed over laser weapons and maneuverability. You're a space trucker, pure and simple. Pack the cargo, get it there fast, get paid, repeat. Life is simple and good. Weightlifting, piloting, and ballistic weapon systems. Shipborne weaponry. Alright, pilgrim. Wayfarer, wanderer, seeker, transient. You've been called many things during your travels and learned something those others could never understand. The journey is the destination. Scavenging, surveying, and gastronomy. There's too many cooking things in this game. Professor, you've always enjoyed learning, but nothing could compare to the joy of teaching others. As humankind spread throughout the stars, there was never a lack of knowledge to obtain, and you gladly assisted. Astrodynamics, geology, and research methods. Professor. Oh, did that. Ronin. Masterless and unbound, you wandered the settled systems of the Blade for Hire. To some, you were a simple mercenary, to others a hero, and to a select few, a nightmare they could never wake from. Dueling. Stealth and scavenging. Sculptor? With your knowledge of anatomy and skilled, steady hands, you could have had a lucrative career as a surgeon. Instead, you followed your heart and created works of art to amaze and inspire. Medicine, geology, and persuasion. Still not completely sure which I'm going to choose. Soldier. The settled systems is no stranger to warfare, and if there's one thing armed conflict relies on, it's trained weapons, trained warriors with guns and guts. You had both. Simple, bloody work, and you were great at it. Fitness, ballistics, and boost pack training. I think I'm going to choose whichever one had stealth. Space scoundrel. Good? Bad? Whose right is it to say? If there's anything you learned while traipsing through the galaxy, it's this. Space may look black, but it's really one big shade of gray. Pistol certification, piloting, and persuasion, and then xenobiologist? The settled systems is home to untold alien species. And while none of them have yet proven sentient, that never deterred you, so you sought out and studied them for whatever gifts they offered. Laser surveying and fitness. And then we got this file not found. Oddly, there was no information on file about your past life. Clerical oversight? Deletion by some unknown faction? Or was there just nothing of note to mention? Whatever the reason, your past is known only to you. What's important is the here and now and the path you're about to forge. Changing his... The change thing doesn't work. Nope. All right. This is the only one with stealth. Working for and against the Megacorp. Often sacrificing conscience for credits. Yeah, I guess I'll choose that. I like the whole stealth and sort of kind of hacking. theft might come in handy. All right, so we got traits. A few. Alien DNA. You volunteered for a controversial experiment that combines alien and human DNA. As a result, you start with increased health and oxygen, but healing and food items aren't as effective. Hmm. Dream home. Yeah, I don't like that. I want healing and food items to be maximum effective as well. So I don't know about that. Dream home. You own a luxurious, customizable house on a peaceful planet. Unfortunately, it comes with a 125,000 credit mortgage with Gal Bank that has to be paid weekly. No thanks. Empath. You are deeply connected to the feelings of others. Performing actions your companion likes will result in a temporary increase in combat effectiveness, but performing actions they don't like will have the precise opposite effect. Hmm. Maybe. Extrovert. You're a people person. Exerting yourself uses less oxygen when adventuring with human companions, but more when adventuring alone. Can't be combined with introvert, obviously. Exerting yourself uses less oxygen when adventuring with human companions. Hmm. I don't know. How often am I going to have companions? Unknown. A Free Star Collective Settler. You gain access to special Free Star Collective dialogue options and better rewards from some missions by the faction, but crime bounty towards other factions is greatly increased. Can't be combined with any other faction allegiance trait. Special Free Star Collective dialogue options. I don't know anything about these factions. Hero worshipped. You've earned the attention of an annoying, adoring fan who will show up randomly and jabber at you incessantly. On the plus side, he'll join your ship's crew and give you gifts. Does he have like a flip kind of blonde haircut? Introvert. You need your alone time. This is the opposite, yeah. Exerting yourself uses less oxygen when adventuring alone. Yeah, I don't think introvert and extrovert really work that way, but I applaud them for putting that in. Kid stuff. Your parents are alive and well, and you can visit them at your home, but you will automatically send 2% of your credits home to them every week. You visit them. Yeah, that sounds neat. Okay. Neon Street Rat. You grew up on the mean streets of Neon. You gain access... So funny, because I'm playing another game called Perihelion, the Prophecy, and that's the name of a city in that game, Neon. You gain access to special dialogue options and better rewards from some missions on Neon. Crime bounty by other factions is greatly increased. Oh, they'll put bounties on you. Oh. Raised Enlightened. You grew up as a member of the Enlightened. You gain access to a special chest full of items in the House of the Enlightened in New Atlantis, but lose access to the Sanctum Universum chest. I have no idea. I do not know if the special chest of items in the House of the Enlightened in New Atlantis is any better than the Sanctum Universum chest. Or worse. I have no frame of reference. Raised Universal. You grew up as a member of the Sanctum Universum. You gain access to a special chest full of items, but lose access to the House of the Enlightened chest. So, if you choose none of these, if you choose neither Enlightened or Universal, I guess you don't have access to either chest? All right, because you're not gaining either. Think about that. Serpent's Embrace. You grew up worshipping the Great Serpent. Grab jumping provides a temporary boost to health and oxygen, but health and oxygen are lowered if you don't continue jumping regularly, like an addiction. Can't be combined with any other religion tree. I don't know. Do I want to jump around so much? I mean, I'm assuming this is only for outside. Otherwise, you can breathe oxygen and stuff like in on ships and stations and stuff. Spaced. Your body has become acclimated to space. Health and oxygen are increased when in space, but decrease when on the surface. Can't be combined with terra firma. Taskmaster. Occasionally, if you have crew trained in a certain ship system, that system will automatically repair itself to full health whenever it is damaged below 50%. However, all crew cost twice as much to hire. Terra firma. You've never acclimated to space. Health and oxygen increase when on the surface, but decrease when you're in space. United Colonies Native. You gain access to special United Colonies dialogue options and better rewards from some missions given by the faction. Crime bounty by other factions is greatly increased. And then wanted. Someone put a price on your head and word has spread. That rhymes. Occasionally, armed mercenaries will show up and try to kill you, but being cornered gives you an edge. When your health is low, you do extra damage. How tough is it when these mercenaries show up? Yeah, I don't really know. I'm kind of blind with most of this stuff. Well, I'm playing blind. I don't like... I mean, I like the fact that there's introvert and extrovert here, but I don't like the fact that you evidently have some minor trouble breathing, whether you have companions around or not. Like, I don't want that to be a deciding factor. Dream home. Oh no, yeah, I don't want that mortgage. Empath. And can I wait? I can undo it. Yeah, I'd like the whole performing actions your companion likes. Sure. I wish I could use 4. Because I'm not sure whether to go for the chest or the special dialogue options. Crime bounty by other factions is greatly increased. Does that mean more people come after you because you have a higher bounty? Is that what that means? Sanctum Universum. I don't know what the Sanctum Universum is all about, but Enlightened sounds like it sounds like it's a like a some kind of organized religion, maybe. Not sure. You know what? I want to get access to some of the special stuff, the dialogue options, and the chest. So I'm going to be... No. Universal. I grew up as a member of the Sanctum Universum. They're probably both religions. Oh, it takes out Serpent's Embrace. And then Freestar Collective. I need more information on the Freestar Collective. Not from you guys, I'm just saying. Wish I could read about them here. But Freestar Collective. Neon Street Rat. Better rewards from some missions on Neon. Well, they both have better rewards. Okay, so we have Freestar Collective, Neon. Or United Colonies. So I grew up on the mean streets of Neon and also grew up as a member of the Sanctum Universum. Sure. Alright, so we got Kid Stuff, Neon Street Rat, and Raise Universal. I got parents. I was raised in the streets of Neon, and I was raised as the Sanctum Universum. Sanctum Universum, okay. What's this? What does that do? Oh, it just... I figured to put arrows, not whatever's going on here. Alright. Finish? Oh, this is the part where people are raging about that you can choose your pronouns. How do you change your pronouns? I don't know. What does she look like? I hit escape. I don't want to be called player. Hold on a second. Looking for... other words for pink. No, I'm not going to call her salmon. Coral? Cora? Maybe Cora. Yeah. It's kind of sort of. Pronoun B. The horror. Alright, confirm.
You were one of the weirdest hires I've ever had.
Thanks.
From hacking computers to digging for minerals. You're lucky our turnover rate is so high. Well, you got the sample. Client's on his way. Then we all get paid.
I can move along.
You remember anything that happened?